Today, we will make the step progress bar web accessible. The step progress bar is a very useful component that helps the user understand the progress that they have made so far in a multi-step application. The step progress bar can be either interactive, wherein user can tap through and make selections to move back to the completed steps, just like breadcrumbs, or it can be non-interactive, that is, it's read-only and its primary purpose is to indicate the progress made so far. We will be covering both interactive and non-interactive step progress bars in our tutorial today. Hi, I'm Shail Singh, and on this channel, I help you build web accessible applications and share awesome UI and ADA tips. First, let's discuss how a web accessible step progress bar should behave when interacting with assistive technologies. First, on page load, a screen reader such as JAWS should announce the current step that the user is currently on. Second, in case you have a single page application and are not reloading the entire page, then JAWS should announce the updated step when the user has moved to the next step. And third, step progress bar should have a visual indicator of the current step to help the users with color blindness. Let's cover the WAI-ARIA attributes needed to achieve the accessibility for step progress bar. Let's begin with interactive step bars. We should use nav tag to group the elements together. Next, we need to add ARIA label to give more context to the non-sighted users. And then add ARIA current equals to true to the step on which the user is currently on. For non-interactive step bars, we should add a role equals to group to the parent div to group all the steps together. Next, we should use ordered list instead of unordered list, because it's a better indication of a series of steps, and using ordered list has better semantic information. Next, we should add SR only to add hidden text for the non-sighted users to convey if the step is completed or not. And finally, we should add ARIA current equals to true for the active step. Now let's jump into our code to develop web accessible step progress bars in HTML. I have a very simple HTML that we will be using to create a step progress bar. I refer to the awesome videos available on YouTube. Now coming back to our code, for this step progress bar, we will be trying to mimic a single page application wherein the page does not reload while we are moving from one step to another. So when I click on next, it should move to the next step. So this green color and this indicator, this line is a visual indicator which signifies what is the current step. And if I click next again, it should go all the way till the shift section. This is our last step. Now coming back to our HTML, I'll walk you through the basic tags that we have in the HTML. So this is my container div, which is having the step progress bar ID. I'm using the ordered list because step progress bar is actually a series of steps. So ordered list makes more semantic sense. The li tags, I have added some classes which are needed for this styling that we see in our browser. And since my card is our first step, so I have added a class isCurrent. So this li tag is having a step container, and within this step container we have paragraph which is holding our text. So we have step text, and then I have a div for this icons that you see. These are the font awesome icons that I'm using, and the class that I have used is step icon. Similarly, we have three more li tags having the same structure as that of the first li tag. Now coming to our JavaScript, I have a very basic JavaScript to navigate from one step to another. Couple of constants which signifies the step list. So this is an array list wherein I'm kept getting all the step containers. So we have four li tags which are having this step container class. And then I'm defining what is the max steps allowed for this step progress bar and what is the current step. So we are starting from step S1. Then I have an onClick event handler for this next button. And within this, I'm making sure that we are removing the classes such as isComplete and adding the classes such as is current for the specific step that the user is on. And finally, I'm making sure when the current step is equaling the maximum step, we need to disable this button. For visual end users, it's making sense that the user can see where the progress is and what is the current step they are on. But for the non-sighted users, it doesn't make sense. So now let's come back to our HTML and start adding the hooks that are needed to make sure that this step progress bar is web accessible. And to begin with, we have to come back to our div. This is our container div, which is having step progress bar ID. We need to add a role so that we can group all the steps within this section together. We will give role equals to group. Also, I would like to add ARIA label so that it provides additional context that what this group is all about. So we can say step progress bar. Next, we have to specify what is the current step that the user is currently on. So if I refresh my page, my cart, this LA tag is the first step. So we need to add an ARIA label. So we can say ARIA hyphen current, and this should be set to true. Next, we need to make sure that this ARIA current equals to true attribute is getting updated for the each step that the user is currently on. For example, if I click on next, the LA tag for my cart should not have the ARIA current equals to true. Rather, payment LA tag should have that attribute, and we can achieve that using the JavaScript. Now let's head over to our JavaScript section and start adding those JavaScript hooks. So this will give us all the containers that we have, the step container section, right? So LA tag is having the class step container. Next, let's paste this section. Now what I want to do is I want to remove the attribute from all the LA tags. So let's say I want to remove the ARIA current attribute. We will be adding ARIA current attribute only to the step which is a current step. We have a class which is current, which is getting applied to the current step on which the user is. So we can identify that using jQuery. So let's have that. So I'll say is current dot attribute. So we want to set an attribute. We want to set ARIA hyphen current set to true. Now let's come back to our browser. Let's refresh this. Let me inspect this element and we will see visually if that attribute is getting removed from the first LA tag and then getting added to the other LA tags as we progress through the step progress bar. Now let me click on next. The first LA tag, that attribute ARIA current got removed, and then we have it on the second step. Now as I keep pressing next, it's getting removed from the previous one and is getting added to the current step that the user is currently on. We'll be using ARIA live to announce the updates made so far. So let's find where this div is ending. We can give announce progress and it should be screen reader only. And then we can say ARIA hyphen live equals to polite. So we want to announce this any updates made to this section once the user is idle and he or she is not making any updates or any interactions with the application. Let's save this. And then we have to update this section when there is a change in the step. First, we have to update when the page loads. Within the JavaScript on page load, we will find this element. We have to use dot since it's a class identifier. And then we have to add some text. So we'll say dot text. And within this, we will update what is the current step. To find the current step, we have a class that we can refer to, which is current. So in our case, it's the mycart. So we'll find that is current LA tag. And then we need to find the text section. So we have dot step hyphen text, which is holding this value. So within this we have a paragraph which is having step hyphen text as a class, and for this one we need to grab the text. So we'll say dot text, and then we can add more meaningful copy text to it. So we can say step, we can give the step count as well, right? So we'll say plus, and then we can grab the current step. Also we can say of, and then the total steps that we have. So we have max steps, and finally we can say is the current step. Now let's save this and view it in our browser. If this div is getting appended, or this the text for this div is getting appended or not, let me refresh this. I'll find that div. So we have my cart step 104 is the current step. We need to add some spacing so that it's clearly readable. So we'll add a space here and then space here. Oops. Okay, let's refresh it. So we have this section which is having area live polite and is having the copy text. My cart step 104 is the current step. Let's add space here as well. And the same thing we need to do once user clicks on the next button. So once we are here, we will add after we have incremented the counter so that it is having the correct information. Let me refresh this. Now let's look at this section. Let's click on next button. This div should get updated. So it's saying step payment step 2 of 4 is the current step. When I click on next again, it says ship to step 3 of 4 is the current step. And finally, we have shipped step 4 of 4 is the current step. Now that's how we can make a step progress bar web accessible. Now let's run JAWS to hear what it reads out when the user loads the application for the first time and is making progress through the step progress bar. Alright, I have my JAWS screen reader running, and let's have a listen what it reads out when the page first loads and as we press next button.
HTML step progress bar. Page has two regions, one heading and no links. My cart step 1 of 4 is the current step. HTML step progress bar. Bar, main region. Next button. To activate, press space bar. Space. Payment step 2 of 4 is the current step. Space. Ship to step 3 of 4 is the current step. Space. HTML step progress bar. Ship step 4 of 4 is the current step.
Alright, so JAWS was reading the current step when the page first loaded, and then as we press the next button, it announced what is the current step. For example, it moved from my cart to payment, and then it read payment step 2 of 4 is the current step. And as we press next button, it keep on updating us. Now that's how a screen reader like JAWS or NVIDIA should update the non-sighted users for any changes done to the step progress bar. Now to make the step progress bar interactive, we can add or we can wrap this section within an anchor tag. We can say anchor and then have an href. For now, let's keep it to hash so we are not navigating to any other section. Let's end this anchor tag and let's wrap paragraph and this div within this anchor tag. Now let's do the same thing for the other li tags. Let me refresh my browser, and once the user starts tabbing, they will be able to tab on the steps that we have in the step progress bar. And that's how they can navigate back to the previously completed steps. Okay, now this is how we can achieve that. Also, we can add, instead of role equals to group, we can use a nav tag bar. So we can have a nav. We can give role equals to progress bar, and then we can move the entire section within this ordered list to the nav section. So this section can go inside this nav tag bar. And this is all for the interactive step progress bars. I believe that this video was helpful. Please like this video to keep me motivated so that I can continue creating great content for you. See you in the next video. Till then, keep coding.